Hi, I'm Kina McGregor. We're going to take a look at Yoga Nidrasana. So the posture from second series called Yogi Sleep Posture. So you would lie down, getting yourself firmly placed on your mat. And the trick with this posture is to get one leg firmly planted behind the head before trying the other, right? So the left leg rotates deep into external rotation. We lift the spine slightly up, reach the shoulder around. And you want to get the leg as far down the back as you possibly can. And as soon as you do, the head reaches back and you want to press the foot into the ground. We want to try not to let that foot slide. Then the second leg, we want to get the right hip into external rotation. First, the feet touch each other. Then you lift the head just enough to create space, but not so much so it slides up. You don't want to stop here because the right shoulder isn't around the calf. Lift the right shoulder, use the feet, push the right foot as far as you can, wiggling around a little bit. And then with your right hand, hold again onto the left foot. Try to get yourself deeper by stretching the feet apart, and then you drop the head back, pressing the feet into the ground, pressing your head into the ground, reaching forward with your arms and all the way around, clasping your hands at your sacrum and pressing your head into the ground. Then the posture can start to be active. You can then squeeze the knees by bending them and push the feet into the floor, pressing the knees into the floor, pressing your head back, pressing your shoulders back, trying to flatten yourself as much as possible. Make sure to suck in the belly to support the spine. We're not pressing the spine into the ground, but you're pressing the knees into the ground, the feet into the ground. And ideally, if you're comfortable in the posture, you could actually think about sleeping.